Hello, writers. Welcome back to my channel. And we have been discussing the elements of an anchor series, which is a best-selling series that will continue to sell for years and years. It's a very long-term strategy. And if you are new to my channel, then I hope that you will check out the playlist down below that has all the videos on building an anchor series and how I sold over 500,000 books so far in my career. And today's topic, we are going to dive into the final element of an anchor series, which is focused releases. All right, so what I mean by focused releases is releases that are back to back to back. So you're not writing in four different series at once. You have committed to this one series so that when you complete a book, readers know that the next book is the one, you know, the next book in the series is the one that's coming next from you. I think that this is something I have learned by making some mistakes in my own career, because when I first started out, that's exactly what I did. I wrote the first six books of my, it was back then, it was called the Peachville High Demon Saga. And I wrote the first six books of that series back to back and released them back to back with nothing else in between. No short stories, no separate genres, no nothing. It was just that series back to back to back. And I think that there was a little bit of magic in that, because people were like, you know, when book four came out, they knew book five was coming. Now, it also meant that they bugged me about it a lot, you know, not really bugged, but, you know, I got a lot of questions about it because people were like, where's book five? Where's book five? Where's book five? But at the same time, that meant that they knew that was what was coming from me, and they were expecting it and they were excited about it. So it was always front of mind from them. After I finished that first six book arc, I started branching out. I started my Eternal Sorrows series. Then I started the Fairhope series. Then I also went back and wrote a side story, some character backstory from my Demon series. And then I started Sacrifice Me and so on. And I started all these different series. So where I'm sitting right now, I have four or five series going on at a time right now. And this is not honestly a place where I highly recommend you go. I am still making money because I have this anchor series and I'm still doing well because I built that anchor series before I branched out. But at the same time, I think that I would be at a different level if I had stuck with this idea of focused releases so that people knew exactly what was coming next for me. As it stands right now, my readers don't always know what's coming next. It's like, is it going to be book 10 of the Demon series, or am I working on Shadow Demons? But when is our Eternal Sorrows coming? It's not only a stressful place for me to be in because I always feel like I'm way behind on something and that I'm disappointing someone, but at the same time, it's also like my readers have kind of said, well, we don't know what's coming from her, so we're just going to wait and hear about it. So it's not like this is on their mind. And they're all really waiting. Number one thing they're most of them are waiting on is book 10 of my series, but I can't necessarily work only on that series because I have all these others that have started. So instead of constantly being like, ooh, book 10's coming, book 10's coming, and it stays in the top of their mind, I'm not saying they've written me off, but they are definitely going, oh, well, maybe she's working on this other thing, so I'm not even going to think about Demons for a while. I'm going to go read these other authors. And that's not exactly where I want to be. Now, I'm not putting myself down because we all make mistakes and it's all a learning experience, but I hope that you can take what I have learned from this and do something better for yourself. Like I said, I'm still making great money, but at the same time, I think I would have been in a better place. So what I am trying to do is this year, my plan is to get out from under all of these series and start completing them so that I can become more streamlined with these focus releases as I build what will be hopefully my second anchor series next year. Long story short, that's just some of my experience, and that's why I'm giving you this advice to stay with focused releases. You choose this one series and you stick with it at least 5 to 6 books before you start adding in other series. If you can do that, then you stay on top of mind with readers. They know exactly what to expect from you. They know what's coming next. They tell more people about the series because they know you're actively working on it. Because let's face it, we are in an indie space where there's no publisher saying you have to work on this. And actually, even in the traditional publishing realm right now, there's a lot of series that are being canceled, and so they're not being finished. So readers are starting to get wary of these long series that might get abandoned and nobody's ever going to finish them. So it's really good if they know you're working on this. So stay with those focus releases, let them know exactly what's coming next. You may not be able to say it's coming out in April or April 15th or whatever, but you can at least tell them, I'm working on it, this is how it's going, and you keep them, you know, engaged in terms of what's coming next from you, and they always know that it's this next book in this one series. Now, also another thing that I've mentioned on this channel many times before is that most vendors, you are rewarded in the algorithms and the market, like it's kind of like free marketing, the faster you can get those books out. Now, there could be a big debate on how fast is too fast. And some people would say you can't go fast enough. Like you could put out a book every week and be hugely successful. And while that is probably true, you have to stop and say, well, how fast can I write and maintain the quality and the integrity of my series? And that is going to be different for every single person watching this channel. For me, most of the time, the fastest I could write something would be, you know, two months if the book is somewhat short or I have a really clear idea of the plot. Sometimes it takes me 9 months to finish a book, and that's okay. Some people can write a book a month, and that's totally fine too. I have another friend that it takes her 3 months like clockwork to write a book, and then it takes her about a month to get it all edited and out. So she comes out with a new book every 4 months like clockwork, and that works great for her too. The key is to figure out what your maximum speed is and to try to, what I would say is, you know, if you're building that anchor series for the first time, to try to put the first 2 to 3 releases somewhat quickly back to back to back. So if you can do 30 days between, do 30 days between. If you can do 60 days between, you know, put one book out in January and then March and then the next one in May, you will do much better than if you put 6 months in between books. But that may not be possible for you. We can talk about strategies of how you could potentially, you know, keep books back and not publish them right away so that you can hold them back for faster releases. But what I have seen just watching other people in the market is that if when you're building your anchor series, you can get those first 3 books out relatively quickly. And by relatively quickly, I mean no more than say 3 to 4 months between books, you're going to build faster than someone that takes a year between books. But I would say after 3 books, you can slow down just a little bit. So let's say for an example, you could put 60 days between books 1 and 2, 60 days between books 2 and 3. Then between 3 and 4, if you've started to see that growth, you could probably take 3 to 4 months. Now, if you can still keep going with that every 2 months strategy, I would stick with it. But if you need more time because the books are getting more difficult to write, or you need to write something in between just to keep your sanity and your creativity going, or you just need a vacation because you've already written 3 books this year, whatever the case is, I think where you want to start spacing things out is not until after book 3 or book 4 if you can manage it. If you can arrange to build your anchor series where you've got the first 3 to 4 books have all come out within no more than 3 months of each other, I think you're going to be on a really good path there, especially if you're not putting out other books and other series at the same time. So that's one of the biggest strategies that I would use if I was launching my career again, like a new career. I would definitely make sure the first 3 books came out within 30 to 60 days of each other. And then I might spread it out to start like every 3 months a new book comes out. That's ideally where I'm headed in the future. Once I get all of my current series finished and everything's off my plate, I would like to get to that point where I can put out the first maybe 1 to 3 books, you know, all within 60 days of each other. And then I can start spreading them out so that I only have to have a new release every 3 months, but I can keep my fans engaged because I'm only focused on one series at a time. That's ideally where I would like to be. And if, you know, if I'm being honest, when I look at some of the most successful indies that have been not just short-term, like skyrocketed through Kindle Unlimited or something over a short period of time, that's not what I'm talking about, short-term success. I'm talking about if you really look at the indies who have been successful for years, like for the past 8 years, or even 5 years or whatever, that consistently sold, you know, they've got that really strong following. Every book that comes out does a little better than the last. Those people have all been focused on one main series and they have releases that come out no more than 4 months apart on average. I hope this series of videos on how to build an anchor series has helped you a lot. And if it has, please leave me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell so that you get notified the minute a new video comes up from me. I have been trying to post every Monday, Wednesday, Friday with a special planner and organizational video coming every Saturday. So I hope you guys have enjoyed that. And that is all for now. I will see you in my next video. Bye.